Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a tutorial for you that started off as a attempt at a summer look and then it turned into more of a silver shimmery look, and I'm not sure if there still is a summer look in anyone's opinion, but I kind of like how it turned out, so let's get started. Okay, we're starting off with eyebrows, obviously, and eye primer already done, just because I feel like it's kind of a repetitive thing. I mean, you all do your eyebrows your own way, and, you know, applying eye primer is not rocket science. Anyway, I'm going to challenge myself today, because, like, I just had no idea for a type of look today. So I'm going to challenge myself and try to do a summer look with the Jeffree Star Cosmetics Cremated Palette. Because, you know, there's a lot of dark shades and a lot of more cool tone shades, so I thought it'd be a fun challenge to try and do something summery with it. Life would be boring if you would do stuff the easy way, you know? But if you want to do it the easy way and just, you know, watch this as a tutorial and play along, then, you know, you can also just use a palette that actually has more summer-toned colors. I'm starting off with a transition shade in the crease bowl to set the crease, the primer in the crease so it won't crease. Yeah. And also, just to make blending easier for the darker colors, or deeper colors. I have absolutely no idea what exactly I'm planning on doing. I think in my review I actually described this as something that reminds me of dried out mummies. You know, old Egyptian ones. It still does, so yeah, that's gonna be a challenge to make a summer look of. Now, I'm going to do this. I'm going to start off with a dark shimmery brown. Because it feels a little bit warmer, or, well, it doesn't feel warmer. It looks a little bit warmer than the nude shade, or... I make no sense today. It looks a bit warmer toned than the matte brown shade in the palette. In the pan, that is. On the eye, it looks just as cool. I'm gonna actually highlight my brow bone first, because I feel like otherwise the shimmer is just going to grab on too harshly to the bare primer that's still there otherwise. And this is gonna make blending there more difficult. But yeah, I'm just going to blend this into the eye like this, or not into the eye, but like from the outside inwards. I really feel like if you would see my tutorials without seeing me apply the eyeshadow, that would be really, really confusing. But anyway, by the way, talking about eyeshadows, that new palette by Urban Decay, that new Naked palette, like, it's been ages since I was actually excited about an Urban Decay Naked palette. Not because they're not good, because I do think they're very good. It's just that me personally, when I go for natural eyeshadows, I usually go for Catrice, because they're also good and they're incredibly cheap. So yeah, like, I just never was really excited anymore about a Naked palette. But then they released the Naked, I think it's called Ultraviolet or something palette. It has warm shades and it has purples, and I love warm shades and I love purples, so I kind of really want it, like, really? Which is surprising to me, because it's usually I just don't really get excited about the Naked palettes usually. Yeah, I think I'm good with this. But anyway, yeah, just don't expect a review. Like, you can expect a review probably somewhere in the future if I do end up buying it. Let me know what you think of the palette, by the way. I'm curious. Would you want to see a review on it? Just don't expect a review at any rate anytime soon, because I'm broke as usual. But yeah, I don't know. I think it looks cool. Then for the next shades, I'm going to go for a, well, this shade basically, and in the pan it looks a lot more peachy. And on the eye it looks very white. I don't necessarily mind it actually, like, it looks very, very pretty. I think it will be a lovely inner corner highlight as well. But I'm just putting it over the eyelids, dragging it to the outer corner, going back to the blending brush and then blending it together. The outer edge, and also a little bit into the crease so it doesn't just stop there randomly. I do think this, like, pulled the summer vibes back into it somehow. Now, instead of an actual eyeliner, I'm going to do this. So I'm just using a black eyeshadow and a very short stump brush. And I'm basically just applying this where I would apply an eyeliner. It's just that this is like, I don't know, like, I, for a summer look, me personally, I usually don't want to add too much uncomfortable things to my eyes. So I'm not going to add a liquid liner, because that's just a hassle to apply if you just want to get out of the house in summer. And I'm also not going to apply falsies, because I just don't feel like it. There's still eyelash glue in my contact lenses from yesterday's tutorial that I filmed. So, yeah. I'm gonna give my contact lenses and my eyeballs a day off and just not wear falsies today. But, yeah, I'm just applying this as a liner. Sort of smudging it out at the top and then I'm winging it out. But not like a sharp wing, but more like a fade. So it just looks kind of, I don't know, smoky. Okay, admittedly, I feel like I may have gone overboard with the shimmer on this look, because literally every single thing turned out shimmery. Like everything. So I think this means I'm going to try to keep my face mostly matte, just to balance it out a little. Now, for said matte face, I don't actually want full coverage. So I'm just applying concealer, you know, like basically in the middle of her face, already did this part a little bit. And just blending it out, just a concealer in the same color as my face. If you do want to use a full face foundation, of course you can, just, you know, do whatever you want as long as your face looks like you want it to look. Okay, unsurprisingly we ended up with a full coverage foundation in the shape of concealer. I could have just applied foundation, but anyway, I'm also going to conceal below my eyes with a more lighter tone. Now for powder, I'm just using my brush. I don't know if it's just like me thinking it's like that, but not actually like that, but I always sort of feel like, for some reason, concealer doesn't go oily on me as quickly as actual foundation does. Maybe because concealer is drier or something. I don't know. So I'm not using a powder puff or anything or a sponge. I'm just using a brush because that's enough for when I'm trying to set a concealer. By the way, the concealer in question is Liquid Camouflage High Coverage Concealer by Catrice. In case you want to know. Now, I feel like my natural shapes of my face are still showing, but I am contouring with a blush just to accent them a little bit more. I'm using this really ancient, old, antique, whatever blush by Essence. I recommend not using a blush that's probably like expired by like 10 years. But I still love this one. Do as I say, not as I do. But yeah, I'm just applying it on the apples of my cheeks as I always would, but also pulling it here below my cheekbone to make a bit of a contour. Whatever blush you use, use one that's matte and use one that's like, you know, a natural shade. Like, if you do this with a hot pink, then it's not really going to look all that natural, so keep that in mind. Now, for highlight, I'm using quite a natural one. This is a white gold one by Kiko. I'll list everything I use below the video, as always. But anyway, I'm not applying too much, because I really don't want to, like, be covered in shimmer all over. Now for setting spray, I'm going to use this highlighter colored setting spray by Morphe. I got this from a friend recently. It's the Continuous Setting Mist Saweet Peach. It literally doesn't say sweet, it says Saweet. No idea if that's a thing or whatever, or joke, or I don't know. But either way, I'm going to use this. Okay, the setting spray now really makes me crave candy and lemonade. I'm not sure if that's a good thing, but it smells so sweet and I kind of love it. Anyway, I'm just going to use a matte dark brown. And I need my eyelashes on the short stump brush and basically just accentuating my lash line there. I really should have used more matte colors. Maybe in the near future I'll do an all matte look or something. Anyway. I don't know. Like, I feel like all the shimmery sort of takes away the dimension in my eyes. Might be able to fix it still. I'll get back to that. Anyway, I'm just going to blend this out with a clean tiny blender just to make sure that there's no harsh line. It's all nice and soft. And then I'm wiping down the brush and going into a white shimmer, because we hadn't used enough shimmer yet, to do a inner corner highlight. Okay, this was a bit of an experiment, but I feel like it worked. I'm not sure if you can even tell on camera, but this eye now has a little bit of the brown matte shade in the crease here, and this eye doesn't. I really do feel like this looks a little bit more defined. Just, I'm talking too fast and I don't give myself time to swallow. Anyway, yeah, I just feel like it defines the eye a little bit more. So I'm just going to do that on this eye as well with a tiny fluffy blender. Detail blender. I have no idea what this brush is called. Anyway, but yeah, this just, like, it won't completely cover the shimmer, obviously. But it's just going to make the shimmer a little bit less shimmery, so it reflects less light. Because, you know, like, laws of physics and all. And thereby, it will just make my eye look more defined, rather than just one big heap of shimmer without much definition in it. So, basically, I'm just here fixing my own mistake. It would have been better if I would have just used a matte brown on the outer corner to begin with. But still, I do think this actually does sort of solve the issue I was having with it. Making sure the edges are nice and smooth. And we're good to go. Now, like I said, I'm only going to go for mascara and not falsies. So I'm going to start off with just curling my eyelashes slightly. And because Yves Rocher, with every single order I make there, keeps giving me free mascaras, I'm going to use an Yves Rocher mascara. Because at this point, I'm at the point where I don't have to buy mascara anymore for the rest of the year. So I might as well use them. This is the Volume Elixir. I gotta admit, I don't really feel like there's a whole lot of difference between the different types of mascaras that Yves Rocher has. In my opinion, this performs about the same as the old Sexy Pulp mascara they used to have. Don't know if they still even have it. I still have it. But anyway, but one thing they all have in common is that they don't really give the huge, huge false lash effect, but they do look very natural and nice. Like, they do make the lashes dark, they do make them a bit longer, in my opinion, in my experience. But even if you're, like, way up close to someone, you know, your lashes still look like eyelashes and not like spider legs. I don't know, they just make mascaras that don't go clumpy, which is very nice. My waterline is going to be pale nude, but yeah, anyway, about the mascara, that's just really also why I love using Yves Rocher mascaras when I'm using falsies. Because even if I put it over top of the falsies as well, it just does not go clumpy. It just looks really nice from up close too, which, I don't know, I kind of like that. Then I'm also going to put my eyebrows into place with a brow plumper. One day I'm going to make the mistake and accidentally use my mascara for it, and it's going to look horrific. I just know for sure. Then, for the final step, I'm going to use lipstick. I'm going to use a shade that fits with some of the flowers on my dress, a pink one. Of course, a matte, because I just don't want to add more shimmer. Yeah. And then we'll be done. And that leaves us with the final results. Yeah, I gotta say, about halfway through I was like, this is going to be a mess and it's going to be a disaster and it's never going to look any good. I still wish I would have made the outer corner matte and kept the crease matte. However, I do feel like it doesn't actually look all bad, especially considering I was going to try to go for a summer look. And like, especially with the light on it, it just looks very nice and bright and shimmery. And I do feel like that works somehow. So yeah, I gotta say, I'm pleased. That's good. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I do at least 2 tutorials per week and then a 3rd random video. Other than that, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!